in the Sierra. That massive amount of snow that they have received this season is obviously very good news, especially for the ongoing drought that we're dealing with. But the issue now is keeping that powder up there and in the mountains in the Sierra as long as we possibly can. Fox 40's Eric Rucker joining us in the studio tonight with why that's so important moving into the springtime. Rucker.
And Eric, that storm that we just had, as Dennis was mentioning, and the next one coming up are warmer storms, meaning rain at higher elevations. Rain that could potentially chip away at our snowpack and put a very big burden on where that water is stored.
It doesn't take a snow scientist to tell you we have received a whole bunch of powder in the Sierra this season.
Compared to an average year, we're way above average.
But since meteorologist Andrew Schwartz is a snow scientist who just happens to live in Soda Springs at the UC Berkeley Snow Lab, we'll just have him do it anyway.
So far this year, we've had a little over 50 feet of snow here at the Snow Lab. Right now on the ground, we've got 14 and a half feet because, of course, all that snowfall compacts over time.
While this is the most snow that we have seen in recent years, the hope now is that it sticks around as long as possible. Warmer weather means rain at higher elevations, rain that can melt a portion of this snowpack. Schwartz explains why this is far from ideal.
During the winter, we often use our reservoirs as flood mitigation, and we need extra capacity in them to prepare for potential flooding events. So if we melt our snowpack too early, we have to do early releases in those reservoirs, and we don't get to capture all of the water from the snowpack that we would if it melted later in the season.
Schwartz does add that if the rain comes down on snow really high up the hill, well, that shouldn't cause snow melt issues.
That rain would realistically filter into the snowpack and potentially freeze and just bulk up the amount of water content that we have in the snow.
Also, that very important question that is asked very often here in California, how does the snow season impact our drought? Schwartz says we will need at least a couple more above average seasons to help us get out of our drought. Eric?